Well, good morning. And this is a bit of a historic morning in that we're allowed to have this both engaging and important and friendly, but yet somewhat bloody debate, where I am taking the side that there is only one dietary pattern proven to reverse our most serious illnesses. We can use the term vegan diet. It's more common now to separate that as a potentially junk food diet to the vegan diet that is a whole food plant-based diet. Very common now in the literature and in the social media sphere of WFPV. I'll stick with that only to distinguish. We're talking about farm-to-table versions, which is what the science has been based on. Nobody has studied what Oreos, chips, and Skittles will do for your health because it isn't necessary to study it, even though it might be devoid of animal products in probably 50% of your diets. But hopefully in the next 15 minutes, we'll move forward. So I am honored to be here. As I say, you're going to take a Hippocratic oath. Maybe I think the oath ought to be, the oath is with the mostest, is our food should be our medicine and our medicine should be our food. Hippocrates said that 2,500 years ago. And it is amazing how he was precise in that statement. He has another very famous statement that the source of all disease is in the gut. We won't have much time to talk about that today, but he was an absolute bullseye in that topic too. So I have to disclose, I'm a 35-year plant eater. I had my last hamburger as an undergrad. I haven't harmed a chicken, a lamb, a fish, or even the vaginal contents of an egg, which is where it comes out of the chicken, and I want you to remember that. This is a debate. We're allowed to be crude and rude. I've been on a billboard that looked over this fine institution for about 4 years. Unpaid position, but I just wanted to disclose. I have my biases, and it's necessary. But what about Dr. Burkhardt? Dr. Burkhardt does mouse research, and I just want you to be sensitive to the fact that both our food chain and our animal chain is based on these little critters. None of us would eat that. I had the privilege at 4 o'clock today to go before the Wayne Board of Governors and read a statement asking for animal research in certain portions of this institution to shut down. So I'm a bit of an activist in that area. But what about Dr. Burkhardt? So he's an expert in neurobiology, and I greatly admire the work he's done. I am also an expert in neurobiology. I've seen Animal House 100 times. And I totally get food addiction. I've actually written about food addiction, but I don't hold myself out to the degree of his expertise and really some great work he's done on methylation and schizophrenia and some SNPs that are very important in that disease. But how can he be unbiased when he works at the cream lab? I ask you that, Dr. Burkhardt. We're talking about animal products versus plant products. And indeed, I went to his website, and of course, in the sense of humor, there is such a lab. I'm not sure it's funded by the dairy, but you should check out his work. It's pretty seminal. And I have one more surprise from his website in a minute that might just undercut his argument in the sense of a debate. But I really could just show one piece of science, and we could stop. And the piece of science is here, and it's a single study in humans, no hamburger needed to be consumed. It is a measurement of narrowing of arteries in humans with two groups of human patients measured at baseline, 1 year and 5 year, where the black dots are a group that over the course of 5 years went from a 41% to a 52% blockage, not a good thing. If this is your heart, you're more likely to have a heart attack or angina. If this is, excuse me for saying this, your pudendal penile artery, you're more likely to not engage in an activity that's considered fairly important for quality of life. And the other group in the white boxes actually goes from 41% down to 37%. And most people would say, if these are two types of approaches to cardiovascular disease, I'm all in for the white boxes. And indeed, this is the data from my Dr. Dean Ornish. I'm going to talk about him for the next few minutes. This is a plant-based whole food diet devoid of any animal product. And this is the diet that was given by their cardiologists in line with the American Heart Association and fairly described as an omnivore diet. So that alone should suggest we can see very different biological responses to the food that we put in our mouth, plant-based versus a mixed an animal-based diet. And this is by no means the worst of the standard American diet over 5 years. But we'll go a bit beyond, because we talked in the first lecture about heart disease being the number one cause of death in America. But indeed, the more important analysis is that 80 to 90% of those deaths are lifestyle-related, smoking, poor diet, and physical inactivity. And as we described in the first lecture, smoking rates are down, exercise rates are up, but less than 1% of America is eating a largely whole food plant-based diet, less than 1%, with the current goal to boost that to just over 1% in the next 5 years. We are in sad and sore shape in terms of achieving Hippocrates' goal of food as medicine. So this is the enemy. Any artery in the body can be anywhere, filled with plaque, barely open, struggling to get blood flow to a vital organ, whether it's heart, kidney, legs, brain. And how could you possibly think that this is a disease that can be halted and reversed by adopting a whole food, plant-based diet? Well, indeed, a very crazy medical student, and that's the truth. This was a medical student who obviously then went on to residency and fellowship in California in the 1970s. Dr. Ornish designed a protocol after visiting India as a medical student. I'm going to take cardiology patients and feed them what I saw in India: vegetables, fruits, beans, legumes, whole grains, spices, cereals. I'm going to ask them to move, do a little yoga, stop smoking, but I'm not going to let them eat any meats, any fishes, any dairy products like cheese. We're going to see what happens to their cardiovascular disease. And at a series of papers culminating in the Journal of American Medical Association, a very fine peer-reviewed journal, 5-year follow-up patients with proven coronary heart disease, the topic of our discussion last hour. If you look at in the group that ate a whole food, plant-based, non-animal diet, 25 heart events occurred in 5 years, 45 of those following an omnivore cardiology-dictated diet. You drop events by half. And the reason you drop events by half is, back in the second look at the graph, you actually can halt and actually reverse heart disease. It's very rare for patients to hear that heart disease and other vascular disease may be reversible. And you can do that with other diseases, and you can do that by adopting a whole food, plant-based diet. Critical data that has never been discounted and has only been validated by other studies. It got such a large database that in the year 2010, Dr. Ornish's program of whole food plant-based disease reversal actually got approval, along with another similar program in Miami, for Medicare approval. Our government pays to teach you to eat his diet, which is devoid of animal products. Whole food plant-based diets are the only diets paid for by Medicare for patients to undergo improvement. They're also the only diet paid for by Whole Food Corporation, as an example, for employees that are struggling with health issues to go through a life transformation week at a variety of centers around the country. Dr. Ornish, sticking with this young upstart, got bored with heart disease after 20 years.